Oh, it's always good to have guests that know something about a topic that we babble on about, which is why we're glad to welcome Daniel Genzik to the show.
Hi, Dan.
Hi, Daniel. It's funny being this side of the camera, isn't it?
Yeah, it's a little bit strange.
Yeah. Now, you do a radio show on Southern FM called
Yes.
Love on the Rocks.
Yep.
So I suppose that you encounter, is that people call in and...
At this stage, I answer emails when I do the show alone, mm-hmm. but most of the time I have guests, so guys and girls coming on.
Talking about relationships and what, relationships on the slide? Is that what the general...
Well, it's, talking about a bit of everything, mostly past relationships, but at the end of the day, the core of it is about dealing with modern relationships and what it's like in the world now.
Something we don't know anything about.
We need you to tell us about modern.
Yeah, we're in Why? Old. Olds are crochener.
Yeah. So now what I find with younger people is that, I don't know if it was easier in our day, whether it was or wasn't, I'm not sure. People find it hard to sort of find people like-mindedness to have relationships. Is it what's going on out there at the moment?
Well, I don't know if it's something to do with all these movies that people are seeing from a young age and they have higher expectations. You know, maybe girls are seeing these kind of guys and they expect, you know.
Johnny Depp.
Just, yeah, so
Nobody
it's really difficult
like
now.
Yeah.
I don't know if that changed. I think we had, we had the Paul Newmans and the...
Yeah.
You know.
I don't... What's different, do you think?
Well, what I'm finding is I'm sort of old-fashioned, so I'll get in a relationship, but then a few years will go by and people tend to... So I'm not blaming women, but just modern people, they tend to sort of be a bit childish, I find. So loyalty doesn't really exist.
So they're scared
anymore.
To commit, or
no,
everyone
just
wants to be more
they
independent?
Something else around and just decide.
The next best thing.
So fickleness.
Yeah.
Everyone's fickle.
Because what's happened with me is I've had three big relationships and all of them have deserted the relationship. And I initially thought, yes, they're right. It was me and I am this and I do have these problems. But funnily enough, all three of them...
And that's the bottom line, right? It's just you. You just got these problems.
Well, of course. But all three of the big relationships, all of them have come back later and tried to rekindle things. So that tells me I'm doing something right. They went off and sort of did their thing and then realised, hold on.
Found they were all crap out there and you were better than the
rest. Well, that I had something. You know, there was
God
that something.
God help this new generation.
It's better to be with someone that's going to stay with you, in a sense, you know what I mean? And that's what they realised, that I was
better
loyal.
The devil you know than the devil you don't.
That's
yeah.
What
or the devil
you're
you've tried.
That's what
is that what it
40s?
Is?
Yeah, you hang with the devil you know.
Is that?
When you're in 20s, as he said, you know, you find someone or maybe, you know. This,
and when you're our
you find
age,
somebody else that's
and,
better.
And when you're our age, you what do? You just, you've forgotten why why
that's
you're in the relationship
yeah,
or
yeah.
why you even want to leave the relationship. You just don't care anymore?
Maybe.
I've always held a lot of importance on the idea of creating a family. So that might be what it's about for me, is that I'm sort of trying to find someone I can trust. I'm thinking down the track. And that's my goal in life, my number one thing, whereas a lot of people aren't thinking about that, I think, now.
So, young people delaying having kids
even
longer now.
Yeah, they
want to
hold it off
now.
Until it's almost too late and then complain about how, I can't find a good guy.
Interesting, isn't it, Barry? Interesting.
Well, yeah, we come from a different sort of.
Well, not really. I mean, in our day, that's what we were doing. We didn't want to get married at 20, years old, like when they're in the 50s. So we were a little bit rebellious.
A little bit.
You wanted to travel. You wanted to study. You wanted to do what you wanted to do. Be independent, and then settle down. Because once you were settled down with the kid, that was it. It was all over. Mm. So I remember us delaying that quite a bit. And I guess your generations are doing a similar thing.
Yeah.
So it's not that much different.
Is there the same amount of parental pressure?
I don't think so. Because the generations are close. I mean, us with our kids, we know them, we grew up with them, we don't push them to get married at 21 or else it's a harper, what will people say? Mm. Whereas in our parents' day, if you didn't have a kid by the time you were 25, you were a spinster, you were something seriously demented about you.
So we blame our parents. It's the parents'
100%
fault.
Always, yeah.
Ah,
but our parents, not us. Not us as parents. I think we're much more together parents.
Oh, yeah, we are. We don't put any pressure on our children. No, doesn't happen.
So when people ring the show, majority, do they, are they people who are in love or are they disillusioned with love? Is it cynical? Is it positive?
It's definitely leaning toward the cynical side, which is what I want it to be, rather than a sort of a very lovey-dovey thing. But I do play only 70s and 80s music, very positive music, but the actual talking, the content of the show does come off. If you just tune in for 5 minutes, you might think, my God, what a negative show, because it's often just talking about the downside of things, but it always ends, it sort of starts positively, then a whole lot of complaints, and then, you know, in the end, though, we finish up with, you know, that love is the thing. Now,
you cover a broad gamut. Your show goes out to the world at large. So you, but being Jewish and involving yourself in the Jewish community and having that sort of circle, do you see differences between the non-Jewish world and the Jewish world when it comes to relationships?
Yeah, well, I would think that in the Jewish world, you've got more of the old-fashioned side. Mm. You do have sort of relationships that start earlier on, maybe high school sweethearts and stay together. So that's a good thing. I sort of tried that myself. Unfortunately, it didn't work out. So here I am,
well,
you know.
You're still young. Plenty of time to work out.
Yeah, I didn't really want to be one of those fathers that's kind of like unable to move very well. And
right, how old are you, 80?
35, but I did...
Right,
I did,
goodness me.
Ancient royal age.
I did injure myself 6 months ago, so
yes.
I suddenly aged a lot. And, you know, whenever you move to get this severe pain, you suddenly...
But you still feel that you'll be more fulfilled if you get married and have kids? Is that how you feel?
Oh, for
age?
Sure. That's my number one goal in life is that's what it's all about for me. I don't believe in life, you know, after death or anything like that. So it's kind of like... I know that the better job I do with my children, if I meet a great woman and have a beautiful family, those, you know, however many kids will sort of, you know, hundreds of years from now, there will be a lot of people on this planet that have all stemmed from me and that girl. And so the better job I do, the better off all those people will be and all the people they encounter every day. It's a big responsibility.
Selective breeding.
Get onto it.
Well, that's very good.
Where are they?
Well, selective breeding. We didn't have that
choice.
We didn't
select well
because
enough.
Our parents would select for us. This is who you, this is the way, this, he's no good. Right, that, so like, there's a lot of judgment. Yeah, we're very judgmental.
I didn't listen
people.
To a thing they said.
No, and look what happened to you. Well, look who you ended up
that's
with.
That's right.
Look at where I ended up.
Could have been the most boring accountant in the world.
I should have listened to my mother.
That's right. You should have.
And speaking of that, we'll be back after the break. We'd just like to thank Daniel for being with us today.
Thanks, Daniel.
That's very good.
Get on.
The show is on Midnight Wednesdays, 88.3 Southern FM.
On Southern FM.
And southernfm.com. It streams live on the web.
Anyone with love or complaints?
Yeah, listen to Daniel.
Listen to Daniel.
And they can go back behind the camera. Thanks, Daniel. We'll be back soon.
Thanks.